Good morning and welcome back to Titan TV. I'm Sabrina Shetmans.
Today is Friday, January 29th, and I'm Haley Ebert.
TGIF. And now for today's announcements.
Seniors, free money is waiting for you. Please stop in the guidance office, check the website, or see Ms. Monroe, college and career counselor, for a list of graduating seniors, scholarships, and opportunities available.
The third and final FAFSA challenge will end February 18th. All seniors are encouraged to complete their FAFSA application ASAP, and then stop by the guidance office with your confirmation to get entered in the drawing. Good luck!
Seniors, this is a reminder that if you qualify for the Bright Futures Scholarship and have not completed your application, please see Ms. Monroe and guidance if you need assistance.
All students interested in taking the ASVAB, please see Ms. Monroe to reserve a spot. The ASVAB will be given on March 30th.
Congratulations to the Ladies Titans basketball team. Now enjoy this video that I made about them.
The world of sports has changed drastically. It went from anyone could come to the games and paying $5 to a certain number of people could attend and having to pay online to go to the games. For example, the University Titans Lady basketball team have been having a stressful season. Although, some games had to be rescheduled on the day of the game because of the coronavirus.
We put a lot of time and effort into our practices, and just for the games to get canceled is disappointing.
When people attend the basketball games, they are required to wear a mask and will get their temperature taken when they walk in. They also must be social distanced, and players also need to wear a mask on the bench.
We have to wear masks on the benches, and I personally sanitize every time I come in and out of the game after like touching the ball and stuff. That's an extra precaution.
A lot of sports didn't think that they would have a season because of the high risk of getting the virus.
Our team was pretty worried we weren't going to have a season this year, and we have 6 seniors, so not having a season would have really sucked. And some of them, not me personally, are trying to get a basketball scholarship, so that would have dented that.
We wish our Lady Titans an amazing rest of their season and to stay safe. This is Haley Everett recording for Titan TV.
PERT signups are happening now. This test is for seniors receiving a concordant score in algebra to graduate, or for students who would like to dual enroll. You can sign up by using the QR code on your posters that are hung around campus with your guidance counselor, or by going to the school website under the testing tab. The deadline to sign up is February 3rd.
And now over to Don with Titan weather.
Well, good morning to you on this frosty Friday. You're looking at a live shot at our Caribbean satellite imagery. You can see that cold front is well to our south, approaching Puerto Rico and Hispaniola, but that cooler air is spilling in behind it. Certainly, temperatures have fallen to near freezing along the I-75 corridor, currently sitting at 44 in DeLand, 47 in Sanford, and 47 in Orlando. Here's a live look at the Sanford Monroe Skycam. You can see that flag kind of blowing there in the wind, giving you an idea that we are going to be talking about breezy to windy conditions developing this afternoon. And when you factor in those drier dew points behind this front, that is a recipe for a fire danger. So we're going to continue to watch the fire threat closely. Of course, outdoor burning is going to be strongly discouraged today. Temperature right now 47 in Sanford with that north-northwest wind about 10 miles per hour, making it feel even colder. Off towards the attraction, SeaWorld, Winter Park, 4 miles per hour, a variable breeze, making it feel a little bit chillier out there this morning. Once again, north and west of the I-4 corridor, that's where we're talking about. Feels like temperatures below freezing, but today, warming up gradually. 62 will be our afternoon high with windy conditions under sunny skies. Once again, drier air is really going to allow that fire danger to become critical this afternoon. So we're talking about those drier dew points, and of course when you factor in that breeze, that's where things get a little bit concerning. You can see that on futurecast, that north to northwest breeze pushing in some of that variable cloud cover by the evening hours and keeping that fire danger elevated. So once again, no outdoor burning today. 62 degrees today in DeBary, 61 back over towards the land, upper 50s along the coast with a breezy to gusty north northwest breeze at times. 45 degrees tonight, upper 30s returning for Marion County. And as we look towards the next couple of days, we're watching another storm system bringing quite a bit of snow off towards the mid plains. Another cold front arriving by Tuesday of next week, getting things even colder. High temperatures may not make it out of the 50s, and overnight lows will certainly dip into the 30s, maybe even feels like temperatures in the 20s. We're going to continue to watch our next front. Back to you guys.
Attention ladies, flag football tryouts will be held on February 8th and 9th from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. on the practice field near the basketball courts. Make sure you have all physical forms completed and turned in so that you can try out. See Coach Ruggie in room 1C107 for any further questions.
That's all the news we have for you today.
Thanks for watching.
And remember, it's all about you.